Darlene Lipsky of County S in Lake Mills.
Well, Nathan pretty much said what I had to say, but I want to know, why don't you just have a single payer?
Yes.
Remember what I said in the beginning of the meeting, that is that interruptions, you know, are not going to be tolerated.
Let's conversation, council meeting.
Okay, would you please sit down, sir? Ms. Lipsky has the floor, you do not. Would you please sit down? Would you please sit down? Thank you for this.
We pay taxes on how much we earn. Why can't we pay premiums on how much we can afford? Have a single payer plan and be done with it.
Well, Obama rejected the single payer plan when he said
no.
Let me say that if we had a single payer plan, we would probably see a limit on how much the government would pay for that national health insurance plan. There's a cap in Canada of 9% of GDP. One of the biggest issues in the British election that is going to be held next Thursday is the fact that the National Health Service in the United Kingdom, you know, apparently is rationing people based upon how severe their illness is and what their age is and things like that. I don't want that ever to happen here. And that's what's going to happen with a single payer plan, because I think we really won't be able to afford, you know, the cost of it. And I think that we've got a $20 trillion debt. We're spending an awful lot of money on ourselves and sending the bill to our kids and our grandkids. People aren't going to lend us money, you know, indefinitely, you know, if the debt keeps on going up and up. And President Obama almost doubled the debt and almost borrowed more money than his 43 predecessors combined, and that's a fact. So, you know.
How can you say that
when
we go and buy the most expensive bomb there is to blow up somebody? Wouldn't you rather save people's lives?
Of course I'd like to save people's lives, but I would point out that about 60% of what the federal government spends is on the so-called entitlement or mandatory spending programs, the three largest of which are Social Security, Medicare, and Medicaid. Now, Medicare and Medicaid are both health care plans, mostly for elderly Americans. In the case of Medicaid, not all elderly Americans. And Social Security is, you know, for people who are over age 62. So, you know, the fact is that...
For years.
Excuse me. Now, this is the sixth interruption, and I don't want to do what I did in West Dallas. If you want to continue the meeting, then listen to the speakers, don't interrupt them, and listen to my response. So the thing is that the military is about 16% of total federal spending, and over half of that is on personnel costs that pay the salaries and the training and housing, you know, expenses of the people who have volunteered to serve their country. So, you know, whacking away at the military is, you know, not going to solve the problem, and a single payer plan, I'll be the first to admit, is too expensive. It hasn't worked in Canada with the caps that the Canadian government has put on it, and there are severe funding shortages in the United Kingdom. Fact is, we don't have the money.
But we have the money to get $664 billion in tax breaks for millionaires.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, now this is strike seven in terms of the interruption.
This is kindergarten.
Even Brian Brown only gets three strikes before he's out. So let's keep it down. Let's listen rather than clap or hiss or boo or things like that, and we will be able to get through this meeting and talk about it because democracy is not served by shouting down people you don't agree with or screaming applause at people that you do. It is served by a reasonable debate amongst reasonable people. Now, you know, in terms of tax breaks, people who pay taxes get the break. People who do not pay taxes do not get the break. Okay, that's number 8, and I'm keeping track up here. 47% of the American public does not pay a federal income tax. You can't give people who pay no taxes a break. Donna Brzezinski, I answered the question.
You said $664 billion. You guys are giving that break to millionaires. Okay.
Number nine.
Are you afraid?
No, I'm not afraid.
Why don't you answer a question?
You know, what I'm saying is that with all of Obama's taxes, the rich got richer.
Yeah.
And that's a fact. Yeah. You know, you look at the 1%, the 1% end up having more of America's wealth after Obama put 2 tax bills through the Congress and signed them, saying that this was tax fairness. That's a bunch of bunk.
But what are you doing on
sir, you have not...
She asked a question, answered the question.
Those were Obama's tax bill breaks.
No,
okay, you want the meeting to be adjourned because it will be your fault if I have to adjourn it for interrupting. Do you want it to be adjourned or not?
Yes.